scientists in Geneva are expected to reveal shortly. They have preliminary evidence that the most coveted and elusive prize in particle physics, the Higgs boson, does exist.
Nicknamed the God particle, it's thought to give atoms their mass and is crucial to our understanding of the universe. Scientists have been using the Large Hadron Collider at the CERN laboratory to smash atoms apart in their search for the particle.
Shortly after the Big Bang, when the universe was created, the Higgs boson came into being and gave all the other particles substance, which is why some refer to it as the God particle. Its discovery was one of the main aims of the Large Hadron Collider, the most powerful particle accelerator ever built under the Swiss-French border. Its collisions are so powerful that they recreate the conditions that existed shortly after the Big Bang. And the hope is to find the elusive Higgs particle.
Even if we do find the Higgs boson, it's not going to be the end of the story. Particle physicists aren't going to shut up CERN and all head off home. I'm sure there'll be plenty more questions to ask, but this has now become the bottleneck. This is the stumbling block. We need to know if this particle exists or not.
There are strong rumours circulating among scientists here that two of the LHC's experiments have found a signal of the Higgs. Even if that's so, the scientists here won't call it a discovery, because at this stage both results may just be blips in the data, which may go away after time. But what's causing huge excitement here is that people are saying that each experiment, using different methods, has found the blips in the same place, and more or less in the location that the theory predicted. If that's so, it'll be described as a hint that the Higgs exists. But as far as hints go, it'll be a pretty strong one. Palab Ghosh, BBC News, at the Large Hadron Collider just outside Geneva.
Well, let's go to Birmingham now and speak to Professor Paul Newman, a particle physicist from the University of Birmingham. This must be a tremendously exciting experiment for you to follow.
I can tell you that there's huge excitement today. In the main auditorium in CERN, the room was completely full 2 hours before the seminar started, and they had security guards stopping people from getting in. People have been working towards this for 20 years or more, and maybe if today we get the first hints that we've really found the Higgs particle, that would be an immense piece of news.
How will you know for sure if you found it, though?
Well, we won't today. I think that's fairly clear. What you can say is that if the Higgs boson exists, and there is still a big if there, given the amount of data that we've collected in 2011, and today will be the first time that that data will be shown publicly by the two big experiments, if the Higgs boson exists, then that amount of data ought to be enough to show some hints of the particle. And I don't actually know, I mean, I work on the ATLAS experiment with my colleagues in Birmingham. I don't actually know what our competitor or our sister experiment, CMS, is going to say. And there will be a seminar at CERN in 10 minutes' time where the two experiments will show their results to one another officially for the first time. And I think if, as you said in your introduction, we both see some sort of a hint of the Higgs in the same place at the same mass, then that would be the thing to get excited about. Still won't be definitive.
I must share a joke with you from Simon Singh from Twitter. The Higgs boson, the God particle, walks into church. A priest says, "We don't allow your type in here." And the Higgs boson replies, "But without me, how can you have mass?" I love it, the fact that there's a particle physicist joke. What happens if you decide it's not there then? Don't you have to throw all of your assumptions out of the window and start again?
Yeah, that would be even more interesting in many ways. I mean, we have a theory, a beautiful theory, which describes more or less everything that we see in our particle physics experiments, except for one thing: none of the particles have mass. And so the Higgs particle is supposed to be a bolt-on or an addition to this theory, which explains why things are massive, and quite clearly we all have mass. If there's no Higgs boson, we need another explanation for the origin of mass, and there are lots of candidate theories out there for what that might be, but it would be in many ways bigger news than actually finding the Higgs.
Somebody who's much cleverer than me has just whispered in my ear, if we've had atoms, we've had quarks, what happens beyond that? Could there be some other kind of particle that we're not even aware of yet?
Absolutely. I mean, the Large Hadron Collider is a new era in particle physics. It takes us into new energy regimes. So in a way, that means that it takes us into a world where we can see smaller and smaller distances. So it's entirely possible that you could even discover, maybe not this year, maybe even in 5-10 years' time, but we could be announcing that quarks themselves have structure. That would be a great result.
We'll have to ask you to explain it for us. Professor Paul Newman from the University of Birmingham, thank you very much, and enjoy the seminar.
That's a pleasure. Thank you.